Hi, this is Munson with Munson Music, and we're going to talk about how you could strum through a song called Bleeding Out by Imagine Dragons. And we're going to end up capoing this on first fret to match the recording, but we're going to start out on an E minor chord. And the way you play E minor, first finger goes to the A on the second fret, second finger goes to the D string on the second fret, and if you strum all those together, that sounds like E minor chord, and it sounds really, really sad. And then from the E minor, we're going to be taking, or another way to play the E minor, is you can take the third finger and go to the B string third fret, pinky on the high string third fret, and if you strum all those together, that sounds like E minor 7, so you might want to write that for your E minors through the song. And we actually start off with just kind of a couple of E minors. One of my favorite strum patterns for a song like this is down, down, up, up, down, up, so you just try that a lot. You'd have down, down, up, up, down, up. It almost sounds like we do a long down, 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 up through the chords, or through the E minor. So we'd have kind of a down, 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 down. And then from that intro, we go into our main verse chorus progression, where we start on the E minor, and then we go to a C major chord. Let me play C major. First finger goes to the B string on the first fret, second finger on the D string second fret, and third finger on the A string on the third fret. And if you strum the A string to the high E string, that sounds a C major chord, and it sounds really, really happy. Now another C you may want to think about is something called C major 9, where you do your first finger on the D string 2nd fret, 2nd finger on the A string 3rd fret, 3rd finger on the B string 3rd fret, and the pinky on the high E string 3rd fret. And if you strum the A string to the high E string, that sounds a C major 9, so you want to think about that for your Cs. And then from the C, we're going to be going to a G major chord, G major. First finger goes to the A on the 2nd fret, second finger on the low E string on the third fret, and third finger on the high E string on the third fret. And if you strum all those together, that sounds a G major chord, and it sounds really happy. Now you might also want to think about taking the third finger and going to the B string third fret, pinky on the high E string third fret. That's another way you could play your G major, and that might make that E minor to the C to the G change a little bit easier. And then from the G, we're going to be going to a D major chord. When we play D major, major. First finger goes to the G string on the second fret, second finger on the high E on the second fret, and third finger on the B string on the third fret. And if you strum the D string to the high E string, then that sounds a D major chord, and it sounds really, really happy. Now on the D major though, sometimes you kind of hear the second fret on the low E string kind of becoming part of the bass on that, and that's called D slash F sharp. And there's a couple different ways you could kind of play that. You could readjust your fingers and do first finger on the low E on the second fret, second finger on the G string second fret, third finger on the high E second fret, and the pinky on the B string on the third fret. And if you strum all those together, that sounds a D major chord, but we've got an F sharp in the bass, so we call that D slash F sharp. Another way to do that chord is to kind of take that regular D shape and then take the thumb and kind of go over the low E string on the second fret, kind of cover that note that way. Or you might want to consider something called D sus slash F sharp, where you do the first finger on the low E second fret, second finger on the G string second fret, third finger on the B string on the third fret, and the pinky on the high E string on the third fret. And if you strum all those together, then that sounds a D sus slash F sharp, so you want to think about that for your D chords too. And that's basically our chord progression through the song, is kind of like E minor, C, G, D. And there are a couple places, especially on the verse, where you kind of hear that becoming almost four downs on each chord, where you may want to kind of do downs and then kind of kill the strings, and that might be kind of a cool way to kind of work that. E down, 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 E minor, C, G, E. Or you could use the down, down, up, up, down, up, and have E minor, down, up, down, up, C. Now the weird part is, to play along with Imagine Dragons, instead of starting on an E minor chord, they're starting on an F minor chord. So to play along with the recording, what you want to do is take a capo, and if you put the capo on first fret, then now your E minor is really an F minor chord, and your C major is really a D flat major chord, and your G is really an A flat major chord, and your D is really an E flat major chord. So you could kind of start that off with that intro, just kind of working that E minor with the down, down, up, up, down, up. Or you might kind of be digging on that down, 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 up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down. And then from there, then we go into our main verse chorus. So you could do that with just that down, down, up, up, down, up, and have E minor down. Might kind of dig on kind of that four down on each one, kind of A minor, C, G, D, E minor, C, G, D. Or a lot of times with a song like this, something else that I like to add is bass notes. And a lot of times on that first down of the down, down, up, up, down, up, or the down, 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 up, you could throw in a bass note for the chord. So on the E minor, you'd have the low E for your bass. On the C, you'd have the A for the bass. On the G, you'd have a low E for the bass. And on the D, you'd have a D string for the bass. Unless you're doing the D slash F sharp or the D slash F sharp, you have a low E for the bass. So we tried our verse chorus with a bass down, up, up, down, up. You have E minor the bass. Down, up. Basics of how you could strum through Bleeding Out by Imagine Dragons. So good luck!